Thank you. to get some space here. Be socially distanced.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good evening. My name is Karina Olette, and I serve as the principal at Grand Star Elementary. With the unique challenges in this school year, we have put a strong emphasis on our social-emotional needs of the students. We had the opportunity during our August professional development to look at what we already had in place and have continued to build on our current foundation. This year, when students arrive at school, they have a minimum of 3 adult contact points prior to the school day starting. Students are greeted in the car loop or when they get off the bus, during temperature checks, and then again by adults positioned in our hallway. This allows us the opportunity to have a positive interaction or pull students aside if they need additional support to transition from home to school. This is our second year at Grand Star to implement a morning meeting and incorporate social-emotional curriculum of second step from preschool through fourth grade. The responsive classroom morning meeting is an engaging way to start the day. It helps to build a strong sense of community within the classroom through 4 components: greeting, sharing, group activity, and a morning message. In addition to our morning meeting, teachers are presenting their second step social-emotional learning curriculum. This curriculum provides language and tools from perspective taking to calming down techniques. The units in each grade level all cover similar topics that build as students get older. The units include skills for learning, empathy, emotional management, and problem solving.
Eyes are watching, ears are listening, voices quiet, bodies calm. This is how we listen, this is how we listen.
Second Step developed a 3-week community rebuild unit this year to address the challenges students have faced in regards to COVID-19. We were able to review these lessons in August and present them in the first 3 weeks of school. It is exciting to know students have practiced these skills and are using these strategies in real life situations.
evening, everyone, and welcome to Gardner Edison High School, where tonight our Trailblazers will take on the Jaguars from Mill Valley High School. I'm Chuck Holmes. I'm here with Coach Larry Fennell on another cold winter night here in Kansas.
Definitely chilly.
Thank you for joining us, everyone. Coach, the Jaguars come in 2-2 in their last four after having beat Olathe East the other night, and the Trailblazers come in 3-1 the last four after beating Shawnee Mission West. So both teams come in playing relatively well. Should be a good game tonight.
Yeah, we're at home, so, you know, nothing like playing at home. And we'll see if we can get this rolling and heat this place up.
Yeah, indeed. Let's talk about our Trailblazers here tonight. Let's go with Jake McClure first, number 22.
Yeah, as we look at these highlights with Jake, you know, the one thing we're going to need for Jake to do tonight is to stay hot from the three-point line. He must stay aggressive. And if they open it up and, you know, if they run him off that line, he's more than capable of taking the ball on the inside and making a basket of that way, and we just need him to stay aggressive tonight.
Yeah, he's averaging 14, almost 15 points a game and shooting 51.5% from the field. Then there's Kellen Keeser, number 11.
Yeah, Kellen's been driving the ball to the basket, and that's worked out very well for us. If he stays aggressive like that and, you know, gets in the passing lanes and makes these easy baskets for us like this, and we're going to need that work tonight, too. Those, get those two guys working together inside out, we're going to have a good night.
Yeah, absolutely. His work down low gets him at the free throw line. We shoot just about 73, almost 74%, 60% from the two-point range. Now we got a scouting report here. Let's talk about Pete Jansen, number 13 for Mill Valley.
Yeah, Pete is 6'3".
Yeah.
You know, so he's going to be rough for us to match up with him and see how he's going to be playing tonight. You know, we've seen some highlights where he's knocking down the three ball and getting a chance to roam around the inside of the paint. We'll have to make sure we know where he's at tonight.
Yeah, he's a 6'3 senior. He likes to get into the passing lane. He can knock a three-pointer down.
Yes, sir.
Then there's the big guy, Adrian Diamond.
Yeah, Adrian is going to be the guy that we're really going to have some trouble with. And Jalabami's going to have trouble with him because he's a pretty skilled big man at 6'7". He can step out and shoot the three ball, also put the ball on the ground and take it to the hole. So Jalabami's going to have to stay out of foul trouble today.
Yep, and as usual, Coach, you know we always have our keys to the game.
Oh, yeah, we got to have the keys.
That's right. So let's talk about our keys here real quick. Let's outline them first, then we'll talk about them. And we look at key number one. You know, we have to be consistent from the three-point line. Key number two, we want to move the ball around. You see here where Jake is being knocking down that three-pointer. If he can continue to hit that three-pointer like that, we're going to be in good shape.
Yeah, we're going to need to be able to, like I said earlier, we're going to have to knock down that three. Jake's going to have to knock that three down today. And we get that knockdown, we'll be just fine. And the second one is really going to be important because the ball cannot stick. We got to get this ball moving around and get these guys moving. Got to get that defense moving to allow us to get some easy shots like that. The next thing we must do is we're going to have someone from the bench come in and step up. You know, whether that be, you know, McClure that's out there by himself, or maybe we're going to need somebody else other than the guys that we've highlighted to come in and do something to help us get this ball going tonight.
Yeah, Joe LeBron is going to need some help down low. Looks like Coach brought somebody else from the JV team to make her to help a little bit out there with Mitch Mock as well.
Yep.
You know, so we're looking forward to these guys playing strong, playing tough. You know, and one of the other keys we really didn't touch on that much was key number two. You know, we're talking about moving the ball around.
Yes.
You know, so they did a good job the last few games of moving the ball around and finding the open shot. So that was outstanding work. So let's take a look at the starters tonight for Gardner Edison. There's number 22, Jake McClure. We're talking about him. Okay, and then there's Ethan Reynolds. Ethan's averaging 13 points a game.
Yeah.
He's really stepped it up here the last few weeks, which is a good thing to see. There's Tyler Butash, number 12, another junior, coming in at 5'11". And then Kellen Keeser. We talked about Kellen.
Yes.
The strength he brings. And then there's Ivan Jolabome. Jolabome is going to need help down low with the rebounding. He's the most consistent rebounder they have. So, you know, Coach Zach White, boys going to have their hands full tonight.
They are.
They're going to come out and play it hard. So I tell you what, Coach, we're going to talk more about this. We're going to have a good time tonight. We're going to take a break. We'll be right back after these messages. You're watching GEHS-TV on MSTC Sports.
My job is to help new homeowners who have turned into their parents. I got into this because I was a sufferer. I turned into my dad, but I came back, and I'm here to help others come back. This is my baby right here, Dr. Rick, on Becoming Your Parents. It came about where my parentology thoughts, I was coming up with so many of them, I thought, I don't need to just have this, the world should have it. So I just birthed it, you know, right out of me. Sometimes we have a victory and I relish those.
Probably need a hacksaw at some point.
Nope.
But most of the time we don't.
General rule of thumb with throw pillows, if there's nowhere to sit, you have too many.
Parentology is not an officially recognized field yet, but I think we're making strides in that direction. You just have to keep reminding them you are your own person. You're not your parents. You're you.
And welcome back to Gardner Edison High School, where we're getting ready to introduce the starting lineup, and we're about to have our national anthem. Tonight singing the national anthem will be Robert Radcliffe. He's a freshman here at Gardner Edison, so we'll sit back and listen to his rendition
That's right.
of the national anthem. Mr. Robert Radcliffe. Anthem.
For the visiting
I'm going to turn over now to our PA system for the starting five.
Evening,
both teams.
Senior, number one, Nick Mason. A senior, number 13, Pete Jansen. A senior, number 25, Aaron Pimhart. A sophomore, number 23, Dylan Blazer. And a junior, number 35, Adrian Diamond, the third.
Five for the Blazers and the starting five for the Jaguars from Mill Valley. Coach, we talked about earlier, they're coming in at 3-1 on the last four. They lost against Shawnee Mission South. But other than that, they've been playing very good basketball.
Hey, right now, there's no place like home, Chuck.
That's right.
You know, we need to warm this gym up. It's a little chilly in here. And it's chilly outside, and we need to get these guys going up and down this court, get a little lather in and warm it up.
Yes, indeed. Well, you know, last time out when we saw them play, they were also very short against the team they play. And I believe it was Shawnee Mission North.
Mm.
And they were able to keep their big men off the boards and then to dominate the game against them. So we're looking for more of this tonight because Mill Valley comes in with a nice tall lineup. As you're looking at number 35 run across the floor, their big man.
Yeah, we're going to have to make sure we keep an eye on him. Butash is going to have his hands full tonight trying to keep that young man that can play inside and outside on us.
Indeed, trouble is open up in the man-to-man, which is their signature defense. Jaguars effectively moving the ball around, looking for the open man. Oh, there's going to be, and Joe Obama's got to get, going to be a little bit of undermanned down there tonight.
Yeah, they're going to, they got, Jaguars have some wide bodies down here. They're going to make life rough for Jalabami today. So someone else is going to have to help us out, Butash, or McClure is going to have to get down in there and help with the rebounds.
Yeah, they're very, already a very physical basketball team. They're in the passing lane. And the free throw is missed. The rebound is missed. And Mill Valley comes out with the basketball. Long three-point shot is good.
Yeah, it's just Nick
Mason knocks down the three-pointer.
It was kind of unfortunate for us on that one, Chuck. It was good defense. Threw the ball away, played good defense, and a little scramble with the ball. And we were out of position with three guys under the basket. It was a man open, and they found him.
Jones Ethan, as Ethan tries to get the ball inside, takes it out, gets it off to Keister. Keister looking. Here comes Jolabami. He fights his way through.
Yeah, that was a good play right there. Jolabami just kind of split that defense and tripped a little bit. Sometimes you see that call foul, but he was able to get that ball up. We just hope his knees are okay after that, taking that little hit.
Yeah. Keister does a nice job getting the ball to him so he can get the ball inside like
yes.
that.
Excellent.
Down low again, but Jolabami helps out against Kephart.
Yeah, he's going to have to help out a lot down there with Ethan's at a disadvantage.
Shot missed by Jansen from the Trailblazers. Gets the ball over to Butash. Butash over to Renner all the way across court. And McClure with the ball at the top of the key. Butash looking to get the ball inside. Gets Keister along the baseline, throws it back out, and there's McClure. Yes!
Yeah, there it is. You got to find the hot hand. We highlighted McClure earlier and said, hey, man, we got to have you knock these threes down tonight. And you know, there's the first one right there, and hopefully that gets him started for much more.
Key number two for our game. Keep the ball moving. Move the ball around.
Yeah, we can't afford to let that ball stick with this team. We're outsized right now, and we got to get these guys moving around.
Huge mismatch between Ethan Reynolds and guarding his man number 25. And this is the guy that can shoot the long three. We're going to have a foul.
That's a good box out by Jalabami down there.
Yeah, we're going to have a foul on Pete Jansen. Jaguars employing some full court pressure. Trouble is doing a good job of breaking the press. Here comes Ethan from underneath. And he gets his own rebound under among the trees. Jake McClure, three-pointer. Go in and out.
Just a little unlucky on that. That's a good look, though, right?
Yes, it was.
I liked him to do that. I like that work by Ethan.
He rested just a little bit. And then we're going to have we're looking at a very physical Mill Valley basketball team right here.
Yeah, it's a little physical right there.
That's yes, indeed.
The big man kind of put it into Ethan's chest and Ethan had a little of that football anyway. Yep. Stood him up a little bit. But we see early the officials may let him play a little bit. We'll see how it transpires here shortly.
Let's see how aggressive the Trailblazers can get, because we've already seen two of the baskets that Mill Valley's knocked down been very aggressive.
They've been very aggressive on the inside. Yes, mm-hmm. The big man going right at him.
Once again, no pressure breaking the press. And we're going to have a foul on number 25, Kephart. As Keister went to drive the lane.
Yeah, it's too early for me to go Jay Billis right now, so I'm going to wait a little bit before I go Jay Billis. Jay Billis would say you got all that action down there, then you call that up top.
Yes, indeed. McClure with the turnaround misses. Mason brings the ball up court for Mill Valley. Mason comes to the free throw line, stops short. Rebound by Reynolds. And here comes Ethan pushing the ball up the floor. It's 3-on-1. And just misses it. But a good job by Ethan getting the ball up court.
Yeah, you got to put pressure on that defense. Ethan, he had a chance to kick that ball up to Jalabami, but he wasn't quite ready for it. And Ethan turned on the Jets and went straight through. And if you can do that and get these big guys in foul trouble, maybe we can help yourself out.
Yes, indeed. I mean, this seems to be part of the game plan for Coach White to get these guys in foul trouble a little bit, because they're definitely pushing the ball up the floor.
Yeah, they're not having a lot of trouble with the press either. They're breaking that pretty good. So when you break that press like that, and a lot of times it's going to be 3 against 2.
Yes, indeed.
You break that press, you got to be aggressive. Go to the hole.
talk about Ethan's productivity is picking up here the last few ball games. He knocks down both free throws.
Yeah, he's going to be huge. If he can stay aggressive tonight, that's going to help a lot. That's going to force Mill Valley to make a decision on how they want to attack us tonight.
Yes, indeed. And again, oh, they're going to push it down low as Jensen is able to muscle his way in.
Yeah, Jensen got down low. I thought Jalabama played that pretty well right there. So we're going to take a look and see what really happened. So it's got pretty good. Yeah, I'm not quite sure, you know.
I think he leaned into him with the body on the shot.
Well, Jay Billis would say we're going to need to reevaluate that.
I thought you were doing it, Jay
Billis.
Well,
I was trying not to, but the guys in the stripes are pushing me that way early.
Jensen knocks down the free throw. Puts Mill Valley up 10-7 over our Blazers. Cross-court pass. Easter has it. Triple team. Man, gets the ball back. Here comes Jake McClure. Jake's going to get it off to Butash. Pushes it out. Houston with the basketball. He's driving the lane. He's going to be fouled by Mason.
And that isn't a foul.
That's it, foul.
That is a foul.
And this is what Kellen Keeser does. He forces you to make a play on him.
Yeah, Kellen puts a lot of pressure on you. The first thing he wants to do is drive at you.
Yes, indeed.
So he's making you defend him.
There's McClure with the basketball. Nice little 15-footer.
Nice. Lost art. That 12-foot shot is a lost art. Everybody either wants to shoot the three or dunk.
That's right.
Knock that down consistently.
Jake with his fifth point of the game already. 22 in the game. Matlock. Mill Valley. He's with the ball now. Gets the ball out to Jensen. He's getting it down low. Gets the ball down low to Blazer. Dylan Blazer.
Yeah, Blazer just kind of slid down the backside of defense. We fell asleep a little bit down there, and Matlock found him down there with a nice bullet pass, and he put it up in and off the glass.
Indeed. Butash with the basketball. And Jensen with his hand on the ball. And we're going to have a foul way across court where the referee right in front of us didn't call it, but the one across the court called the foul. Going to call that foul on Keeser.
Yeah, let's take a look at that replay.
But it's not the referee right in front of us. Well, here's the drive in, the pass off.
It's the kick out. And
there's the pass. And here's the referee pass here. And the referee all didn't across the court calls the foul. So, oh, well. Hey, it is what it is.
Yeah, we can see early
Matt
now that.
Matlock using a glass.
Well, I'll call it for him, glass. I'm not quite sure he wanted to do that, but once again, we can't let those guys get in the paint like that.
It's Mill Valley up 14-9. So I'll just try to answer here. There's McClure with the three, knocks it down.
Jake said, not so fast, sir.
Yes, indeed.
We're still here. This is our gym. I know how these rims are going to make my shot look. It looks good so far.
Gets the ball off to Blazer. Blazer looking down low with Jensen. Matlock driving, throws the ball away.
I got it. I thought he was trying to throw me that pass. No, you see, I had my hands up. I was ready for him.
I was getting out of the way just in case he did come up. Don't want no trouble. I'm too old for that. Reynolds with the basketball looking for a little help. Gets over to Butash. Butash takes it around. Now he's looking for help. Over to McClure. Threw it back to Butash. And Butash drives in. We're going to offensive foul on Butash.
Yeah, I think they kind of baited Butash into that one. And we saw the young man down there. Van Dyke was waiting as he turned that corner. And without having an arc down there, it makes it a little tough for the officials to really know if that guy was under the basket or not. I think he was outside, but.
Yeah. I tell you what, though, I like the fact that he's going to the hoop like that.
Yes.
These guys make a play on you.
Yeah, they got to make a play. You got to force the action.
Yes, indeed.
You know, when you're outside, there's two things you have to do. You have to force the action and you speed the game up sometimes to help you out.
Malachi Taylor checks in for McClure. And Connor had checked in earlier. And there's a three-pointer. Three-pointer by number five, Jace Jackson Van Dyke. Gets Mill Valley up by five. Well, just a little bit over a minute left here in the first period. Keeser once again, driving along. Now he gets the ball over to Connor Elder. Elder back to Keeser. Keeser finds Elder. He's got to give up his dribble, so now he's got to get the ball back out again. Mitch Mock now in the game as well. In the 35, gets the ball over to Elder. Now Malachi with it. Malachi Taylor behind the back. Back over to Keeser. Good man-to-man defense by Mill Valley. Keeser looking to drive and misses the shot. Outstanding defense by the Jaguars.
That's pretty good defense by the Jaguars. And can't say we had bad ball movement. We moved the ball. It didn't stick.
Just couldn't find the open man.
It's just good defense.
Yeah. Coming up on 20 seconds left here in the first period. Jaguars lead 17-12. Uh-oh, Jansen with the free three-pointer. Mitch Mason knocks it down.
Yeah, that was just a shot right there. Sometimes there's not anything you can do when a guy gets hot like that. It's, so far, he's seen to go through twice. Might be trouble. You got to watch him.
Ethan Riddles drives it in, and the Euro step with a nice reverse layup.
Nice, Ethan, nice.
And Emil Valley unable to get a shot off. So, Coach, that's it in for the first period. Trailblazers currently trail the guests, our guests from Mill Valley, 20-14. We'll be right back after this short break. You're watching GEHS-TV on MSGC Sports.
At Price Chopper, we know we're not the only grocery game in town. That's why we're always chopping prices. We're passing along the savings on our fresh cut meat. We're fueling your squad with affordable party trays and meals to go. And scoring you great low prices on all your game day favorites. For freshness, selection, and low prices, Kansas City knows Price Chopper.
Hello everyone, I'm Chuck Holmes. I'm here with Coach Larry Pinnell. And, you know, join us tomorrow, February 12th, when Olathe South will face our Trailblazers. And then again, right here on February 16th, that's on MSTC Sports, when Olathe West will come to town. They'll test our Trailblazers. You can find all the action right here on MSTCSports.com. Coach, so far, Jake McClure's been lighting it up from the outside. Pretty good ball movement for the Trailblazers. But right now, Mill Valley's hot from the outside. They're knocking it down, and they're playing very physical on the inside.
Yeah, it's been a pretty good game so far. And you know, both teams have come out, and you can see their aggression in the game. And we're good. Each team's putting up pretty good shots right now. There's really no bad shots taking place. So that first quarter was pretty quick, and we'll see if we can't turn it around and knock some shots down and keep these guys out. We gotta find Van Dyke.
Yes, indeed.
We cannot allow him to just stand up there and knock down threes on us.
Yes, indeed. So far, Diamond has been quiet. He's only got 2 points. And Ethan splits the defense, and then gets Joel Obama, who uses the rim for his advantage.
Nice. That's a good way to do it, to protect you. You got to protect yourself sometimes. You use that rim as another guy. That defender can't come over there. He gets scared and get his hands caught up in the net.
That's how you negate height for the other team.
Exactly.
Whew, glad I got that out.
It was a tongue twister.
I was getting excited there for a minute. Because I was standing with Joel Obama using the rim. Got two big guys out there. He says, nope.
Yeah, he immediately grabbed that ball and knew.
That's right.
I'm going to the other side. Stop me if you can.
Cross over to Diamond. Back to Van Dyke. Back to Diamond. Diamond looking down low for 32 down there. He finds Schrader, who misses a shot. Here comes Ethan pushing the ball up the floor. Butas was calling for it, and he walks with the basketball.
Yeah, he just drug it a little bit. Not a lot, but just enough for that man, that referee trailing to see that happen.
Yep. Come the Jaguars. Looks like the Trailblazers are going to a 2-3 zone, which they have.
One thing we'll have to be careful with is Van Dyke sliding somewhere without the defense knowing he's there. Give him a free shot.
Watching Diamond down here in the corner. There's a shot, 3-pointer. It's going to be up and missed. Joel Obama with the rebound. Here come the Trailblazers trailing 20-16. Jake McClure goes inside, stops, surrounded by the trees. And nice high pass for Joel Obama. Not quite.
Yeah, I would like to see that pass right there be a bounce pass entry. Make it a little easier as Joel Obama was coming around, and if you throw that ball up high like that, he's got to readjust to get to it. But if you throw a bounce pass across there, the ball's going to come right to where he's at.
That's right. And he quickly can get it back out to Jake, who's off in the corner.
Exactly.
Looking for the three-pointer. So, OK, Okay, Mason with the basketball, gets it over to Diamond. Back to Mason again. 2-3 zone, and number 33 is going to throw it up. He's going to knock down the three. Dylan Blazer.
Yeah, I don't think I have that on the scouting report that 33 was going to stand out there and shoot that shot, but now we know.
Yep.
Let's not let him stand out there. We got to get a hand up in it, at least get a hand up in his face.
They continue to shoot that way. Then they bring the Blazers out of that 2-3 zone there.
Yeah, they keep shooting like that. It'll definitely bring us out of that 2-3 zone.
And we're going to have a foul on Blazer as he's reaching in on Jake McClure. Going to be Blazers' second personal foul. That's the 15th foul. 15th foul on the Jaguars. Buttash in the backcourt. Buttash brings it up, gets it over to Kiesa. Kiesa looking low. Joel Obama with the screen. Here comes Jake McClure with the three-pointer.
Jake said, I'm going to keep my team in this game, and I'm going to shoot that ball from way downtown.
Oh, Metal, I couldn't believe that. He's looked at like, what else can I do with it?
Metal looked around and said, Coach, I'm not guarding him out there. He doesn't get paid to play. That's too far out.
That's right. And then there's Mason with the three. It's short. Joel Obama goes up strong. And on the floor, good hustle by everybody. Buttash with the call, the timeout.
Good. That was good hustle right there. Buttash got down there and grabbed that. Call timeout, helped us out.
Coach takes a 30-second timeout. Wait, Coach is calling his boys together and say, okay, you're doing a good job. Let's look at the upcoming schedule here for the boys. You know, the pandemic continues to affect a lot of student activities. We're privileged to bring you games right here in your living room, offices, and mobile devices. You can find all the games. All the home games right here on GHS TV and MSTC Sports. Tune in every early for every pregame show and stay with us for postgame show. We take pride in making sure you don't miss any of the action right here with the Trailblazers. So as I said, tomorrow, Olathe South, and back here again on the 16th against Olathe West. And then they go to Leavenworth. Play there.
That's a tough stretch of games right there.
That's a tough stretch of games.
That's
and it's still February.
Five games in really? 7 days, eight days.
Joel Obama with the loose and takes it all the way in.
Like we said earlier, Chuck, you break that pressure. As soon as you break that pressure, you immediately go to the rim. You got to put extra pressure on that defense.
Joel Obama's having a great game so far. He's got 6 points. And it's going to be they're going to call on the floor. They're going to call that foul on the floor.
And we'll take a look at that replay. And
Matlock was looking to have it, but he's going to call it on the floor.
We're going to take a look and see what happened.
Yeah, they're going to call it.
Oh, they called it on the floor.
They called it on Buttash. It's Buttash's second foul.
Chuck, I'm going to need to grow about 7 inches to become Jay Billis today.
You don't get that Jay Billis money, so you need to stay who you are.
Hey, but I'm a Trailblazer, so I'm happy that ball didn't go in. You call on the ground all day.
That's right. Trailblazers currently trail 23-21. It's about 5 minutes left here in the second. Ball inbound. Trailblazers switch back to a man-to-man defense. Mason with the basketball. Here comes the screen to be set by Jansen. Goes around, kicks it out to Matlock, who's thought about it. Back over to Mason. Mason to Van Dyke. Back to Matlock. Jake McClure doing a good job down low against Diamond. Diamond, good switch. Trailblazers playing some excellent defense. Making the Jaguars work for this one. Once again, down low. Good job by the Trailblazers. Making them work for it. Jansen with the basketball, nowhere to go with it. Looking to shoot. That's going to be the shot up by Van Dyke, who misses, isn't it?
That was good team defense right there, Chuck.
Outstanding.
The Jaguars aren't having to go anywhere to go with that basketball, and we were right in their shirts.
Kiesa with the ball, takes it all the way to the hoop.
That was one of the keys right there, Chuck. We highlighted that earlier today. Kiesa, that's his game.
That's right.
That's his game. Go straight in. That defense opened up, it parted the Red Sea.
And we are
right down.
And we are tied here halfway through the second period. Diamond with the basketball. Down low. Jill Abami with the knife. And then there's Ethan Reynolds with the rebound. And here come the Trailblazers pushing the ball down court. McClure with the basketball. Oh! I know what he wanted to do.
I understand where he was trying to go with it. And
I know exactly what he was trying to do.
It was a good thought. It was a good thought.
Kiphart checks in. The replay is
you see Keisha
going to the hole.
Excuse me, Mr. Keisha. Called you out your name, sir.
Van Dyke with the ball now. Over to Matlock. Matlock drives the lane, throws it up with the right hand in. Nice move by Matlock.
Yeah, that was just a case of.
That guy looks familiar, doesn't he? Matlock, he looks like he. Yeah, he played with the executive producer's son.
He did.
Middle school.
Yeah, middle school. He's grown a little bit.
Yeah.
We're going to find out why the executive producer's kid didn't grow.
Ouch.
Oh. And we're going to have a foul on the floor. Because Diamond went flying across the lane. Now we're going to have a timeout.
Novello was able to call a timeout.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, we're ready.
So we're looking at Mill Valley right there. And you just see him go. Loose ball and just got a little trip.
Yeah.
Keisha's. So it's amazing that the ball didn't go out of bounds. And
exactly.
His court awareness, he knew he couldn't move anywhere, and he kept his body parallel to the floor. That was pretty good. We'll have to check and see how he's feeling. That's a hard fall. I thought maybe he hit his face as well. It's kind of chilly in this gym, so.
He felt kind of awkward.
Yeah.
You look at him, he was 6'6", about what, 180, 185?
Got a long ways to fall.
Need some more meat and potatoes on him, too. They'll fatten him up here. Put some more muscle on him.
He's just a junior, right?
Yeah, pretty physical as he is right now.
He is playing physical.
That's right. Mason with the basketball. Drives the lane. And left hand. And we're going to have a foul on the floor. It's like Kephart went up strong for the rebound. Foul's going to be on the Connor Elder. Matlock again with the basketball. With the Mason. Mason over to Diamond. Being closely guarded by Jake McClure. He takes Jake up, and they're going to have another foul.
You know, Chuck, that's one of the. We saw a highlight from Diamond earlier, and that's where his game really is. He gets on that block. And
that's his game. He gets along that
block. It's a mismatch.
There
it is. 6'6", 6'7". You know, he's a mismatch for it.
Gonna call that foul on Jake McClure. That's his first. Diamond at the free throw line. Knocks out his fifth point of the game. For the most part, Trailblazers have done a good job on him.
Yeah, they've done a good job keeping the ball out of his hands, really, and not giving him, letting him get the ball in a position where he can do anything with it. And as we see what happens when he can get into position.
And here comes Reynolds.
Nice.
You know what?
That play
doesn't happen without Keiser.
Hey, we talk about it all the time. When you get into the paint, good things happen when you get into the paint, and
those guys
are sitting out there. And we know Ethan's not going to throw up that three, so we look for him to take it down there. But
yes,
the Jaguars don't know that.
Yep. Oh! Now, how often do we see that?
Well, you know, more than we would think.
It's going to be Jaguar basketball.
It's amazing that ball gets stuck right there.
Couldn't do it if you tried.
No, you cannot.
Inbound pass over to Matlock now. Matlock looking from Mason. Mason with the three-pointer.
Yeah, that was just a case of the guy that inbounded the pass is always the most dangerous guy on the floor because you got to go chase him and find out where he's at.
Good move by Ethan. The three-pointer.
Good move, Ethan. And that's what we're going to need from Ethan.
Yep.
You know, we know he can give that to you. And, you know, Matlock did not come out. Establish himself on the defensive end. And Ethan recognized that. He immediately abused him by going right past him.
What he used was that wide receiver speed to get past him.
Exactly.
He looked at him and shifted to another gear, and he was wide open. So good job by Ethan Reynolds at the free throw line, trying to make it a conventional three-point play. Free throws up and good.
Good.
Makes the score 31-28.
We got a good game here, Chuck.
That's right. Minute 30 left here before halftime. Mason with the basketball. Gets it off the diamond. Trailblazers in their signature again. Man-to-man defense. Diamond looking. He can shoot the three out there, but he chose not to. So number 32 will take it. Schrader will do it.
You know, I'm not sure we saw this in the any of the notes that we looked at or the highlights that Mill Valley can shoot the three ball like this.
Yes, they are lighting it up right
they
now.
They are lighting it up right now.
Yep. Bummy with the basketball down low, and Diamond plays the passing lane. Good ball movement as he takes it all the way in with the left hand. Trailblazers have to be careful here. Not to let this get out of hand just before halftime.
It's always dangerous when you want to throw the ball back towards the opposing goal from the baseline area. There's a lot of room for the defender to get in there between you and the ball.
Yes, indeed. We need to finish this half strong. Ethan going to the baseline, cut off, gets it off to Jake. Jake with the three-pointer, in and out. Joel Abame with the rebound, takes it back up. And he misses with his own rebound again, kicks it back out to McClure. McClure over to Keeser. Keeser finds Connor Elder. He misses, and once again, Joel Abame on the board.
Good board.
Keeser with the basketball, so the three, he misses. Connor Elder with the basketball over to Joel Abame. Keeser again coming inside. This time he decides to go low and he misses, and we're gonna have a block on the floor, and Joel Abame's hurt. He went down hard on his knee.
Yeah, looks like they fell into him on, let's hope he's okay. That shot hurts.
Yes, he's hurt.
Catch it on the side like that. That's tough.
Mitch Mock looking to check in. Keeser at the free throw line with it's about 5.5 seconds left here before halftime. Mitch Mock checks in for Joel Abame. He's limping pretty bad. Yeah, hopefully it's just a.
I just hope it's just a shocker.
Yeah.
It goes away.
Keeser knocks the first one down. Going to the locker room early to get a little treatment.
We see that in all sports, but especially football and basketball, guys falling down and someone just happens to be standing there and catches on the side and hope he's okay.
Keister with the second one, it's gonna be short. And the ball's gonna be taken by the Jaguars. Looking down low, Diamond with the basketball. Look, and he's gonna get the shot away in time. So, after two quarters of basketball, it's the Jaguars from Mill Valley 36. Our Trailblazers 29. We're going to be back with some halftime information and some halftime stats. And we'll take a look at some highlights too, Coach. So we'll be right back after this break. You're watching GHS-TV on MSTC Sports.
Food is life. It's the building blocks of our amazing bodies. Food is strength. It powers us in the pursuit of our full potential. Food is energy. It fuels our accomplishments, big and small. It nourishes us in mind, body, and spirit. Food is health, fitness, and our future. For freshness, selection, and low prices, Kansas City knows. Price Chopper. Food is life. It's the building blocks of our amazing bodies. Food is strength. It powers us in the pursuit of our full potential. Food is energy. It fuels our accomplishments, big and small. It nourishes us in mind, body, and spirit. Food is health, fitness, and our future. For freshness, selection, and low prices, Kansas City knows. Price Chopper.
Halftime here at Gardner-Edison High School with the Trailblazers currently trailed. The Jaguars from Mill Valley, 36-29. We've seen a lot of action. Right now, we're going to watch the drum line here from Gardner-Edison High School. And let's sit back and check them out for a minute or two. Thank you. job by some of the Dreamline members from Graduation High School. We'll be back after this short break to talk more about what happened in the first half and what we can expect in the second half. You're watching GEHS TV on MSGC Sports.
Hi, I'm Lieutenant Adam Winters of the Kansas Highway Patrol. The Kansas Highway Patrol public resource officers across the great state of Kansas have a message for you.
3 out of every 4 car seats are installed incorrectly. Please read your owner's manual and vehicle manual to learn how to install your car seat correctly.
When driving on Kansas highways and you see a trooper in a safety vest and you see the orange cones, you're in a construction zone. Please remember, slow down, don't drive distracted, and move over. It's Kansas law.
Now that you've seen us, make sure you see us and all other first responders and road workers. Move over.
On behalf of everyone in our community and in healthcare, thank you for doing your part.
We appreciate your doing your part to keep us all safe.
When in public, stay 6 feet away from others.
Wash your hands often for at least 20 seconds with soap and water.
Wear a mask. Together, we are slowing the spread of this virus.
And together, we are saving lives.
Welcome back to Gardner Edison High School with, I'm Chuck Holmes. I'm here with Coach Larry Fennell, and you know, this is Black History Month, Coach.
Yep.
You know, once there was a great man who said, education is the most powerful weapon you can use to change the world. And that great man was Nelson Mandela. So here in the Gardner Edison Public School District is proud to join our nation in honoring Black History Month throughout the month of February, also known as National African American History Month. This annual celebration commemorates the contributions and achievements of Black Americans and serves as a time for recognizing the pivotal role of African Americans in the story, history of the United States of America. Founded by historian Carter G. Woodson, Negro History Week was first celebrated on February 12, 1926, that's what it was called back then, to commemorate and celebrate the contribution to our nation made by people of African descent. The date coincides with the birthdays of abolitionist and editor Frederick Douglass and Abraham Lincoln. By the late 1960s, the Civil Rights Movement and growing awareness of Black identity, National Negro History Week had evolved into Black History Month on many college campuses. And in 1976, President Gerald Ford officially recognized Black History Month during the U.S. Bicentennial, expanding Negro History Week into a month-long celebration. Called upon the public to seize the opportunity to honor the too often neglected accomplishments of Black Americans in every area of endeavor throughout our history. Since then, U.S. presidents have designated February as Black History Month each year. The theme of Black History Month 2021 is the Black Family, Presentation, Identity, and Diversity, chosen by the Association of the Study of African American Life and History. So, to read more about the history and celebration of Black History Month, you can find resources from your teachers or the celebrated home and more information on AfricanAmericanHistoryMonth.gov. You can also check out the incredible list of influential Black Americans. Coach, I must say, talking about family, I'm glad you're part of my family. We're part of Hindu Productions.
Yes, sir.
Which is part of MSTC Sports. Mm-hmm. And we're a minority-owned company, so as you can see, our young camera people as they're being featured. We have our family members in the truck. We have family members working the cameras. And we just give thanks to Gardner Edison for giving us the opportunity to do this.
Yes.
And to celebrate what we do best and to showcase what we do best. So thank you so much. And we appreciate all the help that we're getting. We appreciate these young men and women. And this is awesome. So, hey, there we are right there. We can see us too. So I'm going to sit down right here because it's too late. I'm not getting up now. I'm too old for this. So, thank you, everyone. We appreciate it, and happy Black History Month. We'll be right back after this break. You're watching GEHS TV on MSTC Sports.
Whereas, Kansas has a rich history as being a part of the Underground Railroad, a network of people who worked together to hide and transport freedom seekers on their journey north. And
whereas the Underground Railroad played a significant role in the elimination of slavery in the United States and was a foundation for future civil rights movements, and
whereas we are deeply motivated by the efforts of the courageous people who traveled the Underground Railroad and looked to Kansas as a gateway to freedom, as they have been a source of inspiration to generations of Americans, and
whereas Kansas has 29 counties who are part of
the Freedom's Frontier National Heritage Area, and whereas the state is home to 21 Underground Railroad Network to Freedom sites managed by the National Park Service, which continue to tell the story about the nation's struggle for freedom that did not end with the Civil War, and
whereas, in appreciation of the efforts of those who manage and preserve the sites of the Underground Railroad in Kansas and those from around the world who have committed themselves to document and share the stories of the Underground Railroad and the enduring struggle for freedom in Kansas.
Now, therefore, I, Laura Kelly, Governor of the State of Kansas, do hereby proclaim September 2020 as National Underground Railroad Month in Kansas and ask all Kansans to join me in honoring those from our past who pursued freedom by traveling the Underground Railroad and in expressing gratitude for those who helped them on their way, and to join together to continue the fight for freedom and equality for everyone.
Trump is inbound the basketball to start the third period here, trailing 36-29 to the Jaguars from Mill Valley High School. Mill Valley opens up in a 2-3 zone. Trumpers did a good job at the first half, coach, getting the ball inside.
Yeah, we pressed the issue a lot and made the Jaguars try to defend us on the dribble. And a lot of times when we do that, you see that skip pass right there, and we do that, we make it tough on teams.
Ethan with the long three-pointer, no good. Great hustle for the rebound, and Diamond comes away with it from New Valley. Nick Mason bringing the ball up. Gets the ball over to Blazer. Surveys the defense as the Trailblazers are in the man-to-man defense. Gotta stop once again. Diamond. Nice spin move.
You know, Ethan and Butash have drawn the short straws. And Ethan was down there having to guard the big man, Aaron, down there. And Butash is having to guard Diamond. And slow. We talked about Diamond earlier. He's got a lot of athletic ability. He play inside out.
6'7". He looks good with the basketball. Butash with the ball over to McClure. Surveying the defense at the top, and he gets the ball over to Butash. He takes the three. A little bit long. Joe Labame is the only one with some rebound, but he can't do it by himself. So here come the Jaguars. Nick Mason with it takes it at the top of the key, and he knocks down a three-pointer.
Yeah, right now Mason just kind of walked into that three, and you know, as a shooter, you love that little screen up top, and nobody's coming out to rush you. Just kind of take your time and line it up. He knocked it down. We got to run him off that line.
You know, Mason wasn't part of our scouting report here, but he looks good, a 6-foot senior.
He was not. We're going to have to add his name on there.
Yeah, he's a nice, smooth jump shot. He touched with the basketball over to Keeser. Another skip pass across to McClure, who throws up the three. No good. Ethan looking for the rebound, gets boxed out by Mason, and here come the Jaguars again, quickly getting the ball up court. And it's going to be a foul on Joe Labame as Jansen uses the head fake to get Joe Labame off his feet.
Yeah, he just, it's old classic head fake right there, and wait for the man to come down and jump right into him. And the ball got up the court on us pretty quick.
This is a critical time for the Trailblazers. They're currently down 41-29. They can't afford to let this get out of hand.
Yeah, we got to be careful right now. This is a time where leagues are. You look up, and next thing you know, we're down 20.
That's right.
You know, we're going to have to do something about that.
Jansen at the line for a second free throw. Knocking both of them down. Puts Mill Valley up 43-29. Easy with the basketball. Over to McClure. McClure to Reynolds. Reynolds takes it inside. The 12-footer from the free throw line. Knocks it down.
Nice. He can turn that corner. Nobody stopped him, and there's that free throw line shot right there. That's a good shot.
You talked about Ethan earlier. He's averaging, you know, 13 points a game. He's really, really picked up his game, which is great to see.
Yes. It is great for us when he can pick his game up and turn like that, take a little pressure off of Jake out there shooting.
It was a long three-pointer. Blazer misses it. Ball's going to be out of bounds. Belong to the Trailblazers. Mm. again, Kellen Keeser brings the ball up floor. Takes it over, and no one's in the middle, so he takes it all the way to the grass, and he's going to be fouled.
And that's going to be a block there, Chuck. That's Jensen didn't quite get there. And, you know, he slid right past him, and Jensen was looking for that foul, but you were not in good position, sir.
Okay, that was great, great awareness by Keeser.
As we look at this replay as he goes across him, he sees him there, and he just kind of slides by him. Anytime you get on the side of those guys, a lot of times they're going to call a block instead of it.
Yes, indeed. That was this foul on Jensen. That's his second. Keller really showed his speed there by getting past Diamond, too.
Yes, he did.
The line for the three-pointer, and it's in and out, and he goes back in. Get the shooter's roll.
And this is where we got to pick it up right here, Chuck. We got to play a little better defense and make these guys one and out and come down and score and put a little pressure on them. We talk right there.
Jolabame is going up.
Jolabame.
He's looking, and he still knocks it down. Outstanding move by Jolabame. Who's having an outstanding?
Outstanding
game tonight.
He's rebounding the basketball and playing a good game tonight. And that's what we just talked about, Chuck. We got a defensive end is where we got to get back in this game.
Yes, indeed.
It's just not all about the scoring.
We're going to have an injury timeout here. I'm going to watch Jolabame with his steal.
Yeah.
And here he comes. Takes a look and see Diamond coming. Sticks it up with the left hand.
He got the end of the backboard.
Looks like Diamond hit his hand on the backboard or the rim. Either way, he hurt his finger.
If it's dislocated, if you put it back immediately, you're better off than letting it stay out too long.
And a short three-pointer. Here comes Keeson with
good
the rebound.
Good box out.
Keeson once again. Reynolds with the basket. Oh, nice little Euro step. And it's going to fall.
Nice. Ethan is going right at him. You know, that's what we need to do right now. We play defense on one side, and the next side we got to go at the rim and make it difficult on him.
Yes, indeed. We're going to have another foul on the floor, too. And then we see Ethan with the Euro step coming in and knocking it down for the two-point play. We're going to have a technical foul.
We had double tech.
Jolabame is going to have a technical foul called on him for one reason or another. Ethan at the free throw line. And misses the free throw.
Yeah, stay on that line, Ethan. Don't slide off that line, man. Stay right there.
Yeah, we're looking at Coach Kurt Bangle from Mill Valley.
Technical foul was called on 13.
Jolabame got called with a technical foul. That's his third foul. Second team foul. And Mason misses a free throw.
That's big. He's kind of short down there. Yeah. We're going to need that guy.
Going to be a two-shot technical. But misses both of them. So, with the ball doesn't lie, as they used to say back when we were kids.
Rasheed Wallace would say, the ball does not lie.
That's right.
So, maybe that technical was not warranted. We're channeling a lot of guys today. We channeled Billis, and now we're channeling Rasheed Wallace. Got anybody else out there?
Good job. As Keeser picks up the loose ball, as McClure calls something to happen. Keeser pushing the ball up floor. Nobody in the middle. Kicks it out to Ethan. Ethan driving the baseline. Gets the ball over to Butash. Misses. And Ethan fighting for the rebound. Comes away with it. Reynolds takes it back up. And Mitch Mott misses it. Puts it back up. And he's fouled.
That's good work, though. They got me up here clapping, Chuck. That's good work right there. That's good hustle. Not being selfish. Ethan puts pressure on the defense and kicks it over. Just
Aaron Kephart with the foul there. Good ball movement as we see Mitch Mott come in, misses it, and puts it back up, but he's fouled by Kephart, and he misses the first free throw.
That's when you pull him to the side, Coach. And Chucky just kind of grabs him and you say, hey, use the glass.
The bank is always open.
It's always open. It's not a holiday.
Mitch at the free throw line, trying to knock down the second one. Puts it up, and it knocks it down.
That's what we need.
Trailblazers is down by four. A little pressure defense. Mill Valley brings the ball up floor. Blazer over to Mason. Mason is Matlock looking to drive the lane, takes it inside. Nice.
Yeah, they let Matlock get along that, get inside that paint, and we talk about it all the time on our side. When you get the ball into the paint, good things happen.
That's right. Tash out top with the basketball, back over to Ethan. Looks like Mill Valley's falling back into the 2-3 zone, and there's Jake. Jake will shoot him out of that zone if he can knock a few of them down. Ethan just standing around, picks the rebound up, the little fire footer, and he falls.
There's Ethan, Johnny on the spot. That's right, good. Now. That ball is finding Ethan, and Ethan is finding the basket.
That's right. Ethan's probably got 14 points
gotta
right
be
now.
Close.
Yeah.
He's got 1-3.
Again, Matlock with the basketball. Kicking it back out to Mason. Mason with the long three-pointer. Mitch Mock with the rebound. And almost thrown away, but Kellen Keeser comes up with it. And here come the Trailblazers, trailing 45-41 with 2 minutes, just a little over 2 minutes left in the third period. Ethan with the basketball now. And ball's gonna be stolen away. Mason with the basketball comes in, knocks it off the glass with a one-hander.
Yeah, Ethan just kind of got locked up, and Ethan went down, and coach was trying to call a timeout, but he had just lost the ball before he called that, so that's just unfortunate right there.
Butach with the basketball, off, over to Mitch Mock, way off in the corner. Ethan working hard down low, he against the, and Ethan! Ethan's feeling it.
I think that's 17 points for Ethan right now, Chuck.
He's got 17 points and 6 boards.
It's a stat stuffer, as we call it.
Mason again with the basketball. He's feeling it, and they're going to call a foul on Ethan on that one, but that's going to be tough to call. But that's what they'll call a foul on Ethan for reaching.
Yeah, he just kind of reached in, and baseline ref called him for it. Let's see what happens. See if I have to beat Jake.
Yeah, he got him on the wrist as he's going across.
Well, the ball is part of the hand, and the hand and the ball are connected. Therefore, you should not have a foul, but I'm not going to be Jay Billis, Chuck.
You can't hit him on the wrist, though, Coach. You can hit him on the hand.
Yeah, the wrist is connected to the hand. The hand's connected to the ball, you know.
And Diamond goes without the basketball. Here comes Jake, and he misses the easy layup. And the ball is... Look at Ethan, Johnny on the spot again. Ethan kicks it out to Keister. Good job. Good hustle by Jake McClure to get the ball back in. And Ethan doing a good job of getting the ball over to Keister. Here comes Jake. Nobody there. And he's going to be fouled as he goes up.
Now, Chuck, we would call that a foul because that would be the forearm and not the wrist.
that's called a mugging that he just took. That's what that is.
Hey, we could talk about them all day. They can't hear us up here.
That's right. That's foul number 25. It's Kephart with his third. And once again, missed the front end of the free throw. CJ coming up.
Well, that's good camera work right there. We'll go ahead and shout out to the camera lady down there. That's good camera work.
That's right. She held her ground. She didn't take anything from these guys.
The camera didn't shift and move or nothing.
Jake. And hoping to knock down the second one. Puts it up. It is good. Trailblazers down by 3, 47-44. We talked earlier in this period, Coach. They couldn't let this get out of hand, and so far they haven't. They've done a good job of coming back on this.
And we've done it on the defensive end.
Yes, indeed.
We've turned them over, and then we went down and scored.
Yes, indeed. Oh, he thought about it. Should have pulled the trigger. Van Dyke with the basketball being guarded by Connor Elder. And we know that Matlock will drive.
Yes, he will.
Here comes Van Dyke looking. He'll take the shot and he'll knock it down.
You know, from my angle, Chuck, I didn't think that he had proper form to knock that down, but obviously he had the right rotation because it splashed down.
Diamond.
We see Diamond.
And that's going to be an offensive foul.
Yes, that is going to be a charge. Jake got down there and got set and got his body in between him and the basket. And Diamond never slowed down. Tried to run him over. So that's good defense by McClure right there.
Indeed.
There you go right there. And see, he's set. He is waiting for him. They're going to call that all the time. It's
That's only his first foul. He's been playing pretty aggressive, but that's his first foul.
That's his first one.
That's the 15th foul on Mill Valley. Not that it means much. Here comes Ethan. Ethan with the basketball. Come out with the shot.
Oh,
just a little bit too strong.
Just a little strong.
I tell you what, Coach, the Trailblazers had a chance to let that quarter get away from them, but they played well. They came in, they're only down by five. So, so that's outstanding, man.
Mm-hmm.
They really had a chance. So, you know what? We did this earlier on Tuesday, but I want to do it again tonight. I want to congratulate Michaela Haskins, the reading specialist at Madison Elementary School, for being nominated and selected as this week's Great Employee Serving the District Award winner. Michaela's being recognized as a result of consistently demonstrating the ability to connect with students, always exceeding expectations as we relate to serving our student body, fellow employees, and the community at large. Michaela is very instrumental with working with kids with dyslexia, educating the staff, and helping these fervent readers. They really want to learn to read.
Yes.
Dyslexia will prevent them sometimes from seeing ways, things that we see things. But Kayla does a wonderful job of educating the instructors, educating the staff, and educating students on what these kids are capable of doing. So congratulations, Kayla. Thank you, Michaela. I keep calling her Kayla. I'm sure that's her nickname. But congratulations, Michaela. We appreciate everything you do. Thank you so much. 49-44 here. Just beginning the fourth period here as Mill Valley will inbound the basketball. Got to get the Trailblazers to hit some more of those free throws, Coach. We be in front right now.
Yeah, this is where it starts on this side, though. We got to play defense.
Yes indeed.
Good limit them up to one shot.
Good box out by Mason with the rebound.
We talked about moving the ball around, and we've done very well moving the ball around tonight.
There was Mitch Mock with the rebound, so, and Malachi Taylor looking to shoot. Ball out to Mock. Mock over to Keiser. Keiser splits the defense, gets it over to Buttash, who gets it over to Mock. Mock's not going to take that shot. Malachi gets it back out front to Buttash. Keiser on the floor. He'll drive the lane. He'll take it up, and he's going to be fouled. Foul's going to come in on number five. It's going to be on Van Dyke.
Yeah, Van Dyke just kind of hooked him a little bit through that knee out there. We'll see what happens here.
Once again, Keller
gets the ball.
Keller's pushing the issue.
Yeah, Van Dyke just kind of slid in there a little bit and caused that contact, and officials called him.
Keller, nice rotation on the basketball. Kellen's shooting 74% from the line, so he's a good guy to have at the line.
Yeah, he's the best person on the team to have at that line right now, and he's confident with that stroke.
Good job. And we got some little pressure from the Trailblazers. Mason's able to split the defense. Diamond with the basketball. He's looking to take advantage over to Matlock. Good job by McClure to cut off there.
Yes, it was.
Backdoor cut. Mitch doing a good job. Once again, outstanding job of cutting off that baseline. Diamond looking for help. And we're going to have collisions going on down low, but they're going to let it go. Mason throws it up with the left hand.
Yeah, that kind of opened up down there, and Mitch didn't step over and trying to prevent his guy from getting it. And he kind of left that lane wide open.
Keiser, once again, the middle's open. He's going to take it, and there he goes.
If you don't stop him, he's going to continue to the rim until you stop him.
Kellen Keiser's got to have, he's close to double figures.
He's got to be, pretty close. Yeah. 11 or 12.
Mitch down playing low down, and he just bumps him with the body.
Just a little body.
No shot, and fouls on the floor. So. Mitch's first foul.
Mitch hitting with 250, and he should have hit him with 240. Might not have moved him with that as much. You know, that's good. You can't let the man just have a lane like that. You got to make him earn it.
And the ball's in bounds. Diamond, he's going to get it. It's hard to stop that, Coach.
It's hard to stop that when that guy starts at the top and he works his way down through
Yes, that's pretty tough. And then, you know, Butash has given up about four or five inches on him. He's able to just kind of sneak in there. As we see, here he comes. He just turns. I see what happened, Mitch.
He's coming off of Mitch.
Yes.
And he misses the free throw. And here come the Trailblazers, trailing 53-48 with 6 minutes left here in the ball game. And Keister once again stops, kicks the ball out to Jake. And we're gonna have a foul on the floor.
Yeah, he got a little high side on Jake, and Jake pressed their shoe and tried to go around him, and Van Dyke just kind of bumped him a little bit too much.
Van Dyke didn't think so, but it was a clear foul.
Well, Van Dyke doesn't have the whistle, so that's not his job. He needs to just continue to play.
McClure at the line. Needs these two free throws. First one's up and good.
Yeah, we're gonna need to keep cutting into this lead as the clock is stopped. And
Jake's shooting 76% from the line, so another guy you want at the line.
Once again, there's someone else we would like to have there taking that shot.
Jake with the second one, and he knocks that one down, and that puts the Trailblazers trailing by three. We're just about less than 5 minutes, more than 5 minutes to play. And we're gonna have a foul on Keister.
Yeah, that's one, as a coach, I would say, hey, Kellen, that's unnecessary. Don't reach in like that. Just cut the ball off. Don't reach in.
Yep.
Move faster. Cut the ball off.
That's the second foul, the 16th foul for the Trailblazers. Next foul on the Jaguars will put the Trailblazers in the 1-1.
Mm-hmm.
That luck with the basketball. He gets it around. He's swinging the ball around. 33 goes in for left hand. And, Jansen comes up with a strong rebound.
Yeah, the most dangerous guy on the rebound sometimes is the backside guy, because, you know, Jake had to turn and look at the ball, and Jansen was just able to kind of slide on the backside and came off hard off that rim.
Pick and roll. Which didn't. Trying to get the ball over. It gets over to Ethan instead. Ethan kicks it out. Butash going in. Kicks it out to Keister, way off in the corner. Once again, a pick and roll. Keister spins off with the Euro step and the basket.
Nice. Boy, what a play right there.
I'm telling you, Keister is playing a ball game tonight, isn't he?
Keister is playing excellent tonight. That is a great decision. No sense of throwing up that three-pointer. Just go down and he hit it with the Euro on the baseline. Excuse me, sir.
Yes, indeed.
Got someplace to go.
That foul's going to be on Diamond, his second, and Keister with the three-point play. He's fired up. You can look at him the way he's playing defense, clapping his hands.
Yeah, when you make buckets, Chuck, that it gives you extra energy on the defensive end, and you talk to the other guy on the other side, say, here I come.
Diamond looking to take over the game. Here comes Diamond with the basket.
Yeah, we don't want that guy to get started right now. This is a tight ball game, and we don't want him to get any extra looks.
Kellen Keister with the basketball, gets it over to Jake. Jake kicks it back out to Keister. Throws it over. That's his. And you can see where Kellen is like, my bad, it's on me. But that's all right, coach.
That's all right. He was looking for his guy. Ethan just needs to grow.
I'll tell you what, coach, we got a good game here, man. Let's catch our breath. Let's get a 30-second break in here so we can catch our breath.
You got me excited tonight.
Yeah, you're watching Trailblazer basketball on GHS TV, MSTC Sports.
All right, everyone, we made it.
My job is to help new homeowners who have turned into their parents.
I'm having a big lunch and then just a snack for
so
dinner.
We're just using a speakerphone in this store. Is that a good idea?
One of the ways I do that is to get them out of the home.
You're looking for a grout brush.
Did he ask for your help?
No.
We all see it.
He has blue hair.
Okay.
Blue.
Progressive can't protect you from becoming your parents, but we can protect your home and auto when you bundle with us.
Keep it coming. You don't know.
Well, coach, we're here for another. This is a great game so far. Like in the last four games, Trailblazers have won three of the last four, and Mill Valley comes in, wins two in a row, wins their last two. And so this is a good ball game tonight. We've got about 4.5 minutes left here. Trailblazers trail 57-53, and, you know, one of the things that we've noticed is Kellen Keister is playing an outstanding game. He and Ethan both.
Oh, yes. They are putting pressure on this Jaguars defense by going to the rim. They're challenging these big guys down low, saying, you're going to have to either stop me or I'm going to score.
Yeah, one of the things I'm noticing, too, is I'm watching Joe Lebomey on the bench. He's got his warm-up on. I'm not sure if he's been kicked out of this game or not.
You know, I didn't see any indication that he's kicked out the game, man. That might be a...
And that's going to be a pass there for Diamond. A little LU pass.
Yeah, we kind of went to sleep on the back end, you know, Chuck. And I've been looking at, watching this game for a while, and I've been wondering where that play was.
Mitch Mott with the basketball, takes it inside, and he's going to be fouled on the floor. That foul's going to be on Diamond, I think. That's going to be his third.
I think they called it on Mason.
They called it on Mason?
Not quite sure. Kind of. We'll take that replay. We'll take a look and see.
Come on, Mitch. You got to hit these, partner.
Got to have those, Mitch.
Got to have these. Yeah, nice little alley-oop.
Yeah, we just kind of.
Mitch knocks down the second one.
We just kind of fell asleep on the backside of that defense. We lost where Diamond was at and kind of slid in.
I think Mitch is going to be there for the rest of the game. I think Joel Obama may have been expelled from this game for taunting early on. You see him sitting on the side over there with his warm-up on, so I think he's done for the night.
Yeah, that's interesting that you get, you know, I have to check the rules on high school basketball, but I didn't think one, foul like that would get you out of the game.
Exactly. Well, apparently it did. There's Jansen with his 10-foot from inside the lane. Kellen again with the basketball, gets it over to Jake. Jake's been quiet here the last quarter and a half. Is playing the passing lane, and they're going to call a foul on Buttash on that.
Yeah, they just let him slide in inside. And you know what we've seen lately, Chuck, is the Jaguars have pushed their defense out to trap Kessler. So if they're trying to trap him like that, somebody needs to be open. But you got to watch that pass coming back across the top side of the key like that.
Yeah, Blazer actually got in and played the passing lane on that. So.
Yeah, that's and watch them passes when you go back up to the top of the key. That's a makes a shorter trip to the other side. Here we go. We're gonna look at Dylan take the next shot. He knocks it down. And, here's where we got to turn it back up, Chuck. We've kind of, you know, a couple unforced errors, and right here on this side is the Jaguars have pushed the defense out to get Kiesler out of there. And once again, we just had that conversation about where do you throw the ball?
Again,
if they're going to come up like that, two things are going to have to happen.
Yeah.
Kiesler's either going to have to back out of it with the dribble, so keep your dribble alive, or Jake is going to have to come straight towards him for a handoff, turn it around, kick it down to the corner. Backside guy comes over to the low block.
Mm-hmm.
Either kick in or skip pass down over here. But you cannot continue to try to pass that ball up top like that because they're playing that there. That's a designed defensive play.
Yeah, they haven't recognized that yet. And good hustle by both teams as the ball is knocked out of bounds by Diamond on the missed free throw. Both teams now are in the double bonus.
Yes, we can. You can see it's good to have the fans in, Chuck.
It's good.
Fans are being vocal tonight.
Unfortunately, most of those fans are from Mill Valley.
Well, there are a few of them.
Here they come with the trap again. Keesler steps through it. Buttash looking to go with the ball. He gets the ball over to Mock. Mock's not looking to shoot out there. Keesler dribbling. Yeah, gets the ball into Mock right there. He's got to go up strong, which he does. Jake McClure with the three. Yes! Oh.
We needed that. That was a big three right there. That allowed Coach to call a timeout and help settle us down a little bit.
That was huge.
30-second timeout trailblazers.
You know, we're watching a great ball game here, Coach, but, you know, our Lady Trailblazers, here's their upcoming schedule. Remember, all their home games will be broadcast right here on GEHS-TV and MSDC Sports as well. So tune in early for our pregame show where we'll offer you an in-depth look inside the team's keys to the game. Stay with us after the game for our postgame show where we break down the game and hear from our coach. You can find it all right here on GHS-TV and MSTC Sports. So their next three games are on the road, but they'll be here February 23rd against the Latham Northwest. So they've got a tough schedule coming up.
Yeah, that is a tough schedule right there, Chuck. That is a tough schedule, but you get to finish off at home.
Yes, indeed. Here's the replay here. We just mentioned it. Jake was kind of quiet the last quarter.
Yeah, but Jake says, I'm always hot from out here. There's never a time I'm not hot out here. And he didn't hesitate to take that shot either.
Really? Get him lit up. And we see Diamond bringing the ball all the way up the floor. He takes the Euro step. No one stopped the ball.
Yeah, nobody stopped that ball.
Hey, we're going to have a technical foul. Yeah, it's going to be a technical foul on Diamond for taunting himself. Not sure what the difference of his time. Watch the replay here as he brings the ball all the way down the floor. Makes a little head fake, takes it up with the right hand.
Let's see what it did that young man say.
He's talking crap. Oh. He's talking as he's running down the sideline, but I think he's talking to his own fans at that end of the floor down there.
At that end of the floor, I understand you wanted to clean the game, not allow the kids to get like that, but these kids are talking to their own fans.
Jake did both of them. Now, I'm not quite sure why he would get a technical foul on taunting and still be in the game, where Joe LeBrone got one for taunting and he's out of the game.
Well, Joe.
Yeah, so.
They only shot one free throw on the tech.
Well, he knocked down both of them.
He knocked them both down. I think Joe LeBrone might be a coach's decision. It might be just one the coach doesn't want.
Keeps his foul, but he doesn't call it. He's looking for the foul, he doesn't get it. Matlock with the basketball, taking it inside, gets it over to Diamond. And lays it in.
Yeah, that sequence was a bad sequence for us right there. And, you know, we thought we were fouled. And
good save by Kellen. And he's going to be fanned.
That's
going to
be a
foul. That's going to be a
blocking foul right there. He never got over.
That's going to be his fourth foul.
Yeah. He never committed. He never committed to actually taking that charge.
Yep.
He knows that Jake is a fullback. He's coming in with a wide load. And if you're not set, he's going to hurt you. Jake's used to contact.
Jake at the free throw line. You know, I'm standing up here watching the steal here. As he, Diamond, not feet are set. Jake knocks down the first one.
Mm-hmm.
I'm standing up here and I'm looking over at the Blazers bench, and Joe LeBrone is just eating himself up. He wants to be in there so bad.
Yeah, I'm going to have someone clear that up for me. If he just received one tech. I thought it was two techs to get you out of the game. So this might be. We'll have to check with Coach after. We'll talk to him later on.
They could really use him right now.
They could.
Jansen with the basketball gets it over to Mason. Mason kicks it out. Matlock with the basketball. Here we go, Coach. What are we talking about, the shot clock?
We talk about the shot clock all the time, Chuck.
They're just going to kill the clock.
Yes, I would love to see a shot clock to. You know, you gotta reward the defense for playing good D.
Yep.
And he walked, but they didn't call it.
Dancing with the basketball. Once again, they're just playing, they're just killing the clock. And this is so frustrating.
Yeah.
You know, if you're a Trailblazers fan, you gotta foul somebody. But it makes it so frustrating for Trailblazers fan. They're playing great defense. They're back in this ball game, and you got a team that just takes the air out of the basketball.
Yeah, they took about 30 seconds off their clock, and you need to reward the defense for playing good defense. Therefore, you put the shot clock in. I don't care if it's 35 or 45-second shot clock, but you have to reward the defense somehow. I would like to see them institute that here.
Well, Matlock helps them out by missing the first free throw, the 1-1. Ethan with the basketball, driving into the lane, throws it up, and it's good. It's going to be a timeout on the floor of the Trailblazers.
That's exactly what you do. That's exactly what you do.
19 points for Ethan Reynolds so far. Yeah. But that's what you got to do.
Correction. It'll be a full timeout.
It's going to be a full timeout on the floor this time. But we look at Ethan as he takes Matlock all the way to the glass, gets it high off the glass and knocks it in.
Yeah, he took a look at Matlock, and Matlock was kind of high side in him, and he decided to use his wide receiver speed and run past him.
We got 106 left here, and we got some emotions going on over here, and I'm loving it. We got some emotions working over here in both of
them. You know, when you have a good game like this, you know, it's everybody gets their emotions going, and, you know, I know the referees want to try to slow it down, but you cannot take the emotion out of the game.
No.
You got to allow the emotion to happen. The fans are emotional. We're getting emotional up here.
Exactly.
It's been a long time since we've been able to get emotional, you know.
Exactly.
What we have to do now is we're down four. It's 106 right now. We're down four. The first thing you got to do is coach has to make a decision. There's no shot clock.
Right.
So in order for you to stop this clock, you're going to have to get a timeout. If you or a foul.
first thing you do is you try to get the steal.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't get the steal, boom, you're immediately fouled.
Immediately
you stop that clock. You take a chance at the line.
Yes, indeed.
You know, right now the Jaguars are shooting okay from the line, but let's see how they shoot when the pressure comes up.
Find out who the worst free throw shooter is and go after him.
Oh, yeah, the stats guy should know exactly who that person is.
Exactly. And there goes the baseball pass deep. He's going to get the ball over to Diamond. He's going to lay it in.
Yeah, that's the last thing you want to do is allow that pass, Chuck. I would always sit somebody at that half-court line and say, do not let anybody behind you.
Ethan working the basketball inside, gets it over to Jake McClure. McClure steps back with a three-pointer. He's short. There's going to be the foul on Mason. Jake had a good look. He's just short on it.
Yeah, that's tough. That is tough. We were right there.
Yep.
Cannot allow that baseball pass like that.
Well, you know, they're putting pressure up front, and it happens. You know,
it does.
You just didn't pay attention to it. It just happened. So there's Mason at the free throw line. Not on the first one.
Yeah, it does. Last thing you want to do when you come out of there, and if you know who your coach knows who the back guy is, I would always say, hey,
yep,
make sure that back guy is on the half court in the circle. Do not let anybody behind
you. Both teams are in the double bonus, and Mason knocks down both of them. Well, Mill Valley a little bit in foul trouble, too, though.
So, they have been in foul trouble.
So if you could make Diamond do something weird and get himself out of this game, that's going to help.
Yeah, he has four.
Yes, indeed. And Ethan.
There it is.
Everything Ethan's thrown up is going in tonight.
Everything's going in
and
tonight.
And there's the 2 points and the timeout again.
Ethan is playing a very good game tonight.
Yes, he is. 21 points for him and 6 rebounds also. But he may have more than that. I stopped counting at 6.
Yeah, that's
– yeah.
This is a stat stuffer.
Yes, indeed. I've got to think that Joe Labonte was tossed out of this game because I can't believe Coach would have him out. I just can't believe that.
You know, it's one of the things that we'll have to ask Coach. You know, some coaches have rules. If you get attacked, you know, you see it a lot in high school. You don't see it so much in college and the pros, but you see it in high school sometimes. If a guy gets attacked, maybe a hard rule by the coach. If you get attacked, you're out of this game the rest of the game.
Yep, that's
you know,
true.
If we lose this game, and, you know, I may not pin this loss on you, but I will remind you that you were disqualified because you got attacked.
Right.
You know.
Well, we'll have to ask Coach that after the game.
We'll check it out for sure.
So, you know, hopefully we'll get a chance to interview the coach. If not, then I guess we'll just have to start our own rumors.
Oh, I'm not going to. I don't want no trouble, Chuck. I don't want no trouble.
Well, we'll start our own rumors. We'll see what happens here.
I don't want no trouble, Chuck. I'm not going to forget, though. I'm going to want to know what happened.
That's right.
I have to go down and ask one of the guys in the strike.
Yes, indeed. Yeah.
Somebody's going to tell me what happened.
I'm sure there's a reason why, but.
I only saw two shots.
Yep.
So if it was a double tack, well, if they kick him out, there would have been some more shots up.
Yep. Well, I tell you what, though, we have seen very good bet. Now, look at this individual inbound play. All 5 guys from Mill Valley are outside, and they all take off running. They get the ball in, and Mason with the foul. And we're going to have a jump ball. Outstanding.
Outstanding. I've never seen that play before, but in my mind, the first thing I said is, who's going long?
That's right.
They kind of had two guys going long, and they had a guy coming underneath, you know.
Yep. And you see the referee motioning for the Mill Valley players to take a seat.
You know, that was one that I just really never understood, Chuck, but, you know, it if you're standing up on the other side of the floor and the ball's on one side, why you need to sit down?
Yeah.
But, you know, that's the rule, so. We got to play live.
They do. Inbounds to Jake McClure.
There's that bounce pass. It's a perfect spot.
Left hand. Trailblazers trailing by 4 with 20 seconds left. They have to foul again. They have to foul somebody. There you go. There's a foul. They know who they want to foul, but, you know, this time, less than 20 seconds, you got to foul anybody with the ball.
Anybody with the ball has to be fouled.
Yep.
Yeah. At this point, you're trying to lengthen the game out.
Yeah. That's what you're trying to do, just stretch it out.
You got to stretch that game out. So, you know, 19 seconds left. You got to foul first guy. See.
You can trade 2 for 3.
You can. You can.
I'm at the line from Mill Valley. Blazer. First shot is up, and it's no good.
You got a chance.
Already that foul paid off.
Right now, everybody must talk, box out.
And they got to box out.
Ethan.
Because Diamond's backing off. He's already got 4, so he's not going to push it.
Yeah, he's not going to push the issue at all.
action out here. Keister taking it all the way to the hoop. With the basketball. And they're going to call the foul.
Yeah, that was just unlucky right there. That was the right idea because Diamond has four, as you were saying. He does not want to come out of this game, so he's allowing you to go and just kind of stepped out of Kellen's hands. And you know, that happens sometimes.
Kellen wasn't expecting. I think Jake just fouled out. Jake McClure, that was his fifth foul. Michael stepped back in. Kellen just lost control of the basketball as he was going up. Neil Valley wanted to travel on him. The ball stuck to his back and he came down with it again.
It was stuck there. It was definitely stuck.
First one's up and good. John Blazer. 73-67. Neil Valley currently leads. 12.8 seconds remaining here in the game.
First things first, box out, get the ball, push, score.
We know
you
Matt
don't necessarily Lock. Need to stop for a three, but.
We know Matlock's going to be hitting the ball, so Diamond's not going to be doing it. So here comes Ethan, pushing the ball up floor. He's going to need a three-pointer here if he ventures. There's your three. And ball's going to be no good. And Neil Valley's going to walk out of here with a victory tonight as they defeat the Trailblazers 74-67 in a very entertaining basketball game, Coach. We're going to talk more about it when we come back, partner. You're watching GHS-TV on MSTC Sports.
Turn today's question.
And back, welcome back here to Gardner Richardson High School.
What will do it? What will turn today's questions into tomorrow's answers that unlocks the mystery of rare childhood diseases? Love will, because love has no limits. And at Children's Mercy, neither do we. With leading researchers working to find the next advancement that will change outcomes, change lives, and change the world. Children's Mercy. Love will.
We'll be tuning in tomorrow night. Hope you do too. Once again, thank you, MSTC Sports, for all the crew, everyone in the truck, executive producer Todd Henderson, Coach Larry Fernell, directors, producers, everybody. Thank you so much. Enjoy. You've been watching Gardner-Edgerton Trailblazer Basketball on GHS MSTC Sports.